can see that. Good morning, welcome to headgraphics.net. My name is Patrick Yurick, and I'm reporting to you from on July 31st from my bedroom in Farmington, New Hampshire. My lovely, amazing bedroom, which I've drawn
all over the walls.
Excuse me for sneezing. Maybe a peek over at my dragon and my messiness. All of the crazy planning nonsense that is the bedroom of Patrick. Yes, a lot of my art is up on the wall. But anyway, this is a place of creative, and it makes me feel comfortable to paint on my walls. I've been doing it since I was a kid, and blah, blah, blah. So anyway, this is an update on the guitar, and, well, let's just take a look at what I've done so far and where I'm at. This right here, I started off with this octopus design because I've been kind of like thinking about it. I told you I wanted to do an octopus and I did. And the way I did this octopus here was I first penciled lightly in. And I should have done some more posts to kind of get into the, like, how I did it, maybe the different steps. And I possibly will on the back side because I haven't done a design here. And I think I might do another pencil design, but I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. But right now, I'm working on this trim that goes around the octopus, because I did the octopus first on the yellow background. And how I did him was, I penciled, and then I went over him with the red, did all his outlines, and then I built up this kind of, the 3D effect, so it looks like he pops off of the page. And how I did this is, like, I wanted to talk about this thing. When I took photography in college, what my teacher called it was accent lights. And an accent light is basically when you have a main light source that's coming this way. So, like, I know that the tentacle here is getting the main light source. So, like, it's going to slowly spread from this direction coming in. It's gonna spread, the light source is gonna spread, and then slowly turn into a red. Now, what about this line right here? Well, that's an accent. And what that means is there's another light source possibly coming from behind, and it actually makes the character pop in another way. When you have multiple light sources, it's going to make your 3D objects and your cartoon character, if you will, pop in a different kind of way. And I was like I didn't know what to do around the edge. I tell you the truth, like, I was kind of perplexed on what was I going to do around the edge. So what I did was, I've been reading this book called No More Secondhand Art by Peter London, and I love this book because it basically gets me thinking about my own logic when it comes to art. And he talks a lot about meaning and exploration and non-judgment. And what non-judgment is like, and this is what I want to practice in my classroom, no art is bad. And the primary function of an artist is to go where it's uncomfortable. Do experiments. Don't try and make things look good. Just try. Like, and this is kind of interesting. So I did this finger painting kind of just to get myself revved up, because I haven't been posting, and the reason why I don't post sometimes is because I don't feel like posting. I'm not in, like, the greatest place in my head, and I think this is coming around because the energy that I'm getting from my home when I come home, because I'm not in Maine right now, I'm at home, and the energy I'm getting from my home is great, and I love it. So, what I did was finger painting, and up here, as you can see, it's kind of messy and all abstract looking, and it was like that all around. And yes, this is going to make my finish be a little bumpy, but I'm not as I just got yellow paint, see? Yellow paint all over my hand, and I smudged it over here. Luckily, because I've been an artist forever, I know that no matter what mistake I make, I can work with it to make it look like I did it on purpose. And that's the sign, I believe, of any artist, is make all your mistakes into a positive advancement. So, anyway, so I'm working on this part up here, and what I did was, this is abstract. On one of my old guitars, typically I've worked, this is the first guitar actually that I ever painted. And typically I work in cymbals and lightning patterns. As you can see, there's eyeballs and peoples and miscellaneous nothing nonsense. And like, I love it. I mean, I'm not saying I don't like it, but I had the need to move on. And this guitar, I'm doing a lot more color study and abstraction. I'm trying to work with the natural lines I see and pick up some of the natural things, and what I'm saying is, like, sometimes I'm just looking at it and I feel the color should be where it's at. I'm trying to look at the screen while I'm talking. But, like, I'm finishing when I feel it's finished. And I'm not trying to make eyeballs or anything in particular. I'm trying to let it move me. And this is inspired greatly by the abstract expressionist work of Vasily Kandinsky. He has a great book. I haven't read it yet. I wish I could. I need to read it. But his work was inspired by creating a symphony out of color and shape. And expressionist artwork is about honoring the process it takes to create over the product. And that's what I'm trying to do with the guitar. That wasn't what I was trying to do with the octopus. So I'm mixing media, so to speak. Like, I'm doing abstract, making it more familiar, going back to the abstraction, and then making it more familiar. An abstraction, for me, is like the finger painting. Do what feels, do what comes. And then creating something, for me, is like doing the octopus, where it's an obvious object. And I'm mixing that up. I'm trying to push myself in new directions by not confining myself to saying, like, this is how the guitar should look. This is my plan. I'm not following the plan. So we'll see how it comes, and as I continue it, I'll show you more and more of what I'm doing. And I'm going to do more of what techniques I'm using, because I think that's going to be more interesting for everyone out there to see, like, how am I creating this in a step-by-step kind of way. So, have an enlightening day, and I hope to see you back again at headgraphics.net, and, I'm glad that I got to post again. Alright, see ya.